back, sports gamers. It's The Natural here with Danny Jugan, developer and creative Axis Football, with part two of our discussion as we talk about Axis Football 18 dropping this summer on PS4 and Xbox One. We touch on many of the new improvements in the game, a franchise feature even Madden does not have, as well as his take on Gridiron Champions quest to bring back college football video games. Enjoy.
Yeah, and one of the big things I like to see the big, huge expansion and playbooks in this year's game. Can you kind of talk about that expansion? It's kind of, when, what's your process for playbook and play creation? How you go about that?
Sure. So in 2017, if we're just looking on the offensive side, we had about 100 plays total, and those 100 plays were spread across about 7 formations. And one of the consistent points of feedback that we got was that that wasn't enough depth for an offense. Not only that, when you pick a team, you want that team to have its own identity when you're playing with it. And in 2017, all 32 teams had the same set of plays. And so you didn't really get a feel for the team that you were playing with because they all had the same plays. And so we wanted to create different playbooks that could be associated with an identity in a team. And so we went out and just, again, on the offensive side, we're looking at about 60 offensive formations with over 1,000 plays in 2018 with what you can expect. And the process for creating plays, we set up a coding system that basically allows you to fill in the blanks to create a play. So you specify whether it's a runner pass and the specific type of runner pass, and if it's a pass, what kind of drop back the quarterback has, and all these sort of variables that just get filled in. So it makes the play creation process faster, and it also sets us up for, in the future, creating an interface where the user can create plays and fill in those gaps rather than a coder. And so that's definitely something that we are looking at for next year, a play editor.
That'll definitely be a welcome addition there. One of the big things that people love is head-to-head online play. Can you talk about online play and any online modes in Axis Football 18?
So again, this was one of the things that we debated about internally rather heavily, whether or not to look at offering online play. And at the end of the day, we came down to the decision that online play is really important to users, but it's not as important as gameplay in franchise mode. And so we made the choice to hold off on online play until the gameplay was better. We felt like nobody really wanted to play online with their friends if the gameplay was crappy, basically. And so we thought we needed to improve that first, get that right, and then look at adding online play.
Okay, well, that leads us right into franchise mode, which is one of the most popular modes in sports games across the board. Can you speak about franchise mode in Axis Football?
Absolutely. So in 2017, we added drafts, the ability to cut players, but there was a lack of control that you had over your team. Players didn't retire. There was no free agency or trades. You couldn't hire a coaching staff. And so we knew that if we wanted the Axis Football identity to be largely around franchise mode, that this is one of the areas that we needed to expand. And so what we're adding in 2018 are all of those missing components that you could expect to have in a normal franchise mode if you were actually running a team. Things like free agency, things like being able to trade players, and players progress naturally already. They get better or worse as they get older, have a good season, and that sort of thing. But we wanted you to be able to hire coaching staffs and have the coaching staffs really affect what's going on, not only with the playbook, but your coaching strategies during the game, and that sort of thing. And we wanted to really bring an economy into the franchise mode, and not only a way to earn money, but also how you can spend that money. Because some of the things we were talking about internally on our team is that some of the downsides to the way some other games have implemented franchise modes, it's really easy to earn money, but you can't really do anything with it, or you can't do anything meaningful with it. And so that's one of the areas that we are really trying to improve, to make it engaging, to make it realistic, to make the choices that you are making meaningful and not just buttons you're clicking.
Wow, coaching staff, that you guys actually beat Madden to that punch. That's something that people have been asking about for a while.
Well, there you go.
With such a small team, you know, how are you guys been able to pull that off? You don't have a huge, you know, $1 million budget like some other titles. You know, how are you able to do this and each year improve, like, you know, so much from year to year with just a really, really small group of guys?
Well, let me start by kind of explaining what our team is. I don't know how familiar people are with what we're working with. We basically have about a half dozen guys who all work part-time on this. And when you look at the amount of time that we spend collectively, it's roughly the equivalent of what one full-time person would be. And so when you ask the question, how does it get done? The honest answer is, I don't know. It must be a God thing is all I can say. I can tell you that the members of this team are amazing. And this game wouldn't exist if it wasn't for them. We make a little bit of money, and about 95% of that money gets pushed right back into the game. And so I think that accounts for some of it. If you look at what this team has been able to do with the resources, both financial and time, and then imagine what we could do if we were able to actually have the money to open a studio and hire full-time people, which is something we could do in just a short few months if this game does well.
So speaking about the team, it seems such a dedicated team. Like, how did going to console for the first time kind of change your development schedule and process?
It basically moved everything up about 4 months, which was a little stressful, to be totally honest, but we got this. Basically, we are really comfortable releasing on Steam. We've done it now. This will be our fourth year on Steam. We can go from having nothing set up on Steam to being fully released in about a week. It goes real quick on Steam. Consoles are another beast, and anyone who is familiar with the process know that it takes several months to go through the certification process, which means if we want to release in August or September, our game needs to be ready about now. And so that moves everything up 3 or 4 months. And that's one of the main changes. And so we are trying to adjust as best we can for that. This first year that we're going through, there's is a bit of a learning curve as we figure out how we do builds, how we do testing, all that sort of stuff on these different consoles. And so the next year dev cycle, we will kind of front load things a little bit more. It's a learning process, but we're going to get it done.
Any support for Xbox One X, a PS4 Pro, or 4K?
There won't be 4K. We expect the game is going to run better on those, but there won't be any noticeable graphic differences. Again, that's something that we'd love to do, but not where the focus is this year.
What's something that you can say that one thing you can kind of, or not one thing, a couple things you can hang your hat on and you say that, you know, Axis Football does this that no other game really offers out there offers right now?
Well, I'd like to put that hat on the franchise mode, and what wow. What we're gonna, and that's a big statement because I know a lot of people have been wanting that for a while, and we feel like that's the area that we can make the biggest impact in the shortest amount of time. You know, just being completely transparent, Madden does a great job. Producing a game that looks great, and the animations and all of the quality that you see when you watch a Madden game, you take every negative impression of it aside, it looks great. And we, at this point, can't compete with that. But we can compete in franchise mode. And that's where we are going to hang our hat. That's where we're going to give fans what they have been asking for. And we're going to work our butts off to get there.
The franchise guy, definitely excited to get my hands on that. There's been a lot of hoopla news. I mean, it's pretty crazy on IMV Gaming bringing college football back. Kind of what are your thoughts on that around Gridiron Champions?
Well, you talk about a couple guys who had a vision and didn't take no for an answer and stuck with it and kept working. I've got nothing but respect for those guys. Definitely hats off to them. They put in the work, and they have achieved a huge milestone in getting that process started. And, you know, they've got their work cut out for them. Creating a video game, creating a football, a sim football game, is certainly no easy task. But and I've told them this on social media. If they ever need anything, just to reach out to me. Like I said, I've got nothing but respect for those guys, and best of luck to them.
One of the things people keep mentioning is about the legal trouble they might run into with trying to do that or have a user customization in their game. What you guys have been using example to show that you have a full editing roster where people can go on. They have created actual NFL teams in your game. Are you worried about any legal ramifications from that, or do you think anything could come of that that can hinder them going forward with that?
So I've checked in with a couple of different lawyers, just making sure that we were covered. And from what I understand and experience, by the fact that no one has reached out to us with any sort of cease and desist or stuff like that, my understanding is that as long as the game does not ship with the content, and we're talking about copyrighted logos, player likenesses, all that sort of stuff, as long as the game doesn't ship with it, that's fine. If it's user created after the fact and added to the game, it's okay. And so as long as that is the approach taken, then there shouldn't be any legal issues.
What's something that you would say that was the biggest hurdle for you guys that you would say for someone else coming into this space and trying to create a football game? You can say watch out for this, or this is our biggest thing that was really tough for us to overcome.
I think AI is the toughest one, and that's my specialty. I almost got a PhD in artificial intelligence for games, and I struggle with implementing a lot of this stuff. It's challenging, it's fun, but like we talked about earlier, with so many moving parts and instant replay and the ability for people to go back and watch, it's difficult. And even when you watch football games, people make mistakes all the time on the field. And so to try and get somebody to do the right thing in the right situation with all of the various factors that you can imagine, it's tricky. And so I would say AI is at the top of a very long list of difficulties. Yes.
All right. Thanks. Well, I appreciate you hanging out with me, Danny, and answering a ton of questions. Definitely looking forward to X Football 18 on consoles. We can't wait to get our hands on it, and especially that franchise mode.
Well, thanks again for having me on, and thanks again for all the support.
I really hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you did, drop a like. And if you love our content here at SGL, subscribe and turn those notifications on so you don't miss more exclusives from Axis Football and your favorite sports games. It's the natural sportsgamersonline.com. I'm out.
I was in the bando a long, long time. Need to get the Lambo and drive. I was in the lab, you were on my mind, but all I really do is just go.